Jesus the Christ loves you and bless you. 1 Corinthians chapter 1. Paul, called to be an apostle of Jesus Christ through the will of God, and Sosthenes our brother, unto the church which is at Corinth, to them that are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, with all that in every place call upon the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, both theirs and ours. Grace be unto you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank my God always on your behalf, for the grace of God which is given you by Jesus Christ, that in everything you are enriched by him, in all utterance and in all knowledge. Even as the testimony of Christ was confirmed in you, so that you come behind in no gift, waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall also confirm you unto the end, that you may be blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, by whom you were called unto the fellowship of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you all speak the same thing, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. For it hath been declared unto me of you, my brethren, by them which are of the house of Chloe, that there are contentions among you. Now this I say, that every one of you saith, I am of Paul, and I am of Apollos, and I of Cephas, and I of Christ. Is Christ divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Or were you baptized in the name of Paul? I thank God that I baptized none of you, but Crispus and Gaius, lest any should say I had baptized in my own name. And I baptized also the household of Stephanas. Besides, I know not whether I baptized any other. For Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with the wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputer of this world? Have not God made foolish the wisdom of this world? For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God, it pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. For the Jews require a sign, and the Greeks seek after wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified. But unto the Jews a stumbling block, and unto the Greeks foolishness. But unto them which are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God, and the wisdom of God. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than man, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. For you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. But God hath chosen the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. And God hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and base things of the world, and things which are despised God hath chosen, yea, and things which are not, to bring to naught things that are, that no flesh should glory in his presence. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, that according as it is written, he that glorieth, let him glory in the Lord. Chapter 2. And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God. For I determined not to know anything among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear, and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in the demonstration of the Spirit and of power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to nothing. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom, which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, I have not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. But God has revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God, which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judged of no man. For who have known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. Chapter 3. And I, brethren, could not speak unto you as unto spiritual, but as unto carnal, even as unto babes in Christ. I have fed you with milk and not with meat, for hitherto you were not able to bear it, neither yet now are you able. For ye are yet carnal. For whereas there is among you envying and strife and divisions, are you not carnal? And walk as men? For while one saith, I am of Paul, and another, I am of Apollos, are ye not carnal? Who then is Paul, and who is Apollos? But ministers by whom ye believed, even as the Lord gave to every man. I have planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. So then neither is he that planteth anything, neither he that watereth, but God that giveth the increase. Now he that planteth and he that watereth are one, and every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. For we are laborers together with God. You are God's husbandry, and you are God's building. According to the grace of God, which is given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth thereon. But let every man take heed how he buildeth thereupon. For other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, stubble, every man's work shall be made manifest. For the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. If any man's work abide, which he have built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. Know ye not that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temples you are. Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seemeth to be wise in this world, let him become a fool, that he may be wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God. For it is written, He taketh the wise in their own craftiness. And again, the Lord knoweth the thoughts of the wise. They are vain. Therefore, let no man glory in men, for all things are yours, whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas or the world or life or death or things present or things to come, all are yours, and ye are Christ, and Christ is God. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 through 3. Let us turn now to Philippians chapter 2. If there be therefore any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels of mercy, fulfill ye my joy, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind. Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than themselves. Look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being in found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Wherefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Do all things without murmurings and disputings, that you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in the world, holding forth the word of life, that I may rejoice in the day of Christ, that I may not run in vain, neither labored in vain. Yea, and if I be offered upon the sacrifice and service of your faith, I joy and rejoice with you all. For the same cause also do ye joy and rejoice with me. But I trust in the Lord Jesus to send Timotheus shortly unto you, that I also may be of good comfort when I know your state. For I have no man like-minded who will naturally care for your state. For all seek their own, not the things which are Jesus Christ. But you know the proof of him, that as a son with the Father he hath served with me in the gospel. Him therefore I hope to send presently, so soon as I shall see how it will go with me. But I trust in the Lord that I also myself shall come shortly. Yet I supposed it necessary to send to you Epaphroditus, my brother, and companion in labor and fellow soldier, but your messenger and he that ministered to my wants. For he longed after you all, and was full of heaviness, because ye had heard that he had been sick. For indeed he was sick, nigh unto death. But God had mercy on him, and not on him only, but on me also, lest I should have sorrow upon sorrow. I sent therefore the more carefully, that when you see him again, you may rejoice, and that I may be the less sorrowful. Receive him therefore in the Lord with all gladness, and hold such in reputation, because for the work of Christ he was nigh unto death, not regarding his life, to supply your lack of service towards me. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and doing of his word. Now, we are 15 minutes and 30 some seconds into this recording. This reading was done on purpose. The title was given on purpose, although I may change it at a later date. But initially, I just entitled this with the scripture reading. Excuse me, I'm going to drink a little water. The reason I entitled this initially with just the scriptures is because I only wanted to share this with those whom the Lord has called me to share this with. In my previous videos, I stated that I would want to discuss with those who have been such wonderful and faithful viewers, friends, subscribers of this channel. And that's who I intend to speak to, those whom the Lord has called. And I believe that those whom the Lord has called love the Word of God. So if I only came on here and just read the Word of God, you wouldn't mind, because you're not here for me. You're not here for personality. You're not here to look at me. You're not here for any other reason. You're here for the Word of God. And I thank God for your lives. Now, there may be a few who have listened and you're still not called to this channel. I don't send you away. I pray that something will be said to benefit you. And I pray that God will give you spiritual ears, that when you hear this, the intent in which I share this would not be lost in the translation. All right. And those who will listen to this afterwards, because of the someone has recommended that they come and listen. God bless you too. All right. So as you can see, if you've observed the channel, you see that I've made some changes. I've closed comments and ratings. And I am doing this now for a number of reasons. I am in transition. I feel that I owe you, those whom God has called to this channel, an explanation, because you know that I've always been communicating with you all. And I like hearing what the Lord has shared through you after sharing a message. I respect your opinions. I expect your perspectives. I have been blessed by them. I have been enlightened by them. I have learned from them. I have gained revelation. I've gained understanding. And I believe I've gained a greater and a better walk with the Lord from fellowshipping with those who are truly called to this channel. You have been a blessing to me. Believe me. You just increase my life and increase my faith in Christ Jesus. So for those of you who fit into that category, and you know by the Spirit, the Holy Spirit will bear witness with your spirit. And so I just say thank God for your lives. I truly thank God for your lives, and I give him all the glory for allowing our paths to meet. Now, when I first came on, I have been given special, I believe, not, you know, he didn't speak and clouds did not open and say, thus saith the Lord, do this, do that. But the Holy Spirit speaks to us sometimes in an audible voice, sometimes through his word, his written word, most often through his written word. And then there are times that he speaks to us through impressions. Now, those impressions have to line up with his word. Okay. I've seen so many times where people come on and say that the Lord has called them to this channel. And let me just say this. I'm going to say a couple of things in here that's going to offend some people, and then it's going to give others a better understanding. Okay? My intent is not to offend. The reason why I read the Word of God is because I don't want the purpose and the intent to be lost in the translation. So I want you to really go back and listen to what was read. Listen to what was read, because there was a purpose for the Lord allowing me to read those specific chapters. Okay? Don't just pick out one line, but Really read it with the eyes and ears and the understanding of the Holy Spirit. All right. So for those who are called here, I do feel that I owe you an explanation. And oftentimes when you are operating on these types of platforms, you can lose focus of the purpose for which you are called to that platform. Now, I don't think that I have lost that purpose, but I've seen that purpose threatened. Okay. And when I say threatened, there are various ways that it has been threatened. It has been threatened through soul ties. It has been threatened through friendships. And when I say friendships, for example, recently several times, let me just say this. I've had several accounts of when I've shared a message and uploaded a message where I've received inboxes from people saying, was that for me? You know, was that because of this or that because of that, or because of some video that I've done, or someone who they may have not said it themselves, but someone else may have sent a message. And I said, you know what, I didn't even see that video, because I make it a point, as led by the Spirit of God, not to watch a lot of videos, so that in my relaying the message of God, it's not contaminated, it's not influenced by any other thing. I had an instance the other day with a good friend sent me a message, and I had already recorded a message and uploaded it. I didn't read their message until after I recorded it and uploaded it. And after I read their message, I said, you know, I'm glad that I read this afterwards, because I would not have uploaded the last video had I read their message prior to the upload, because I would not have wanted to offended them, or I would not have wanted to sound as if I were speaking about their situation. And it was so funny. She even sent me a message and asked me if it was for her. And I said, you know, I hadn't even read your message. And that's just one example. She and I are fine. There's no problems, but that's one example. And when I said to her, I would not have uploaded it, I felt that check in my spirit from the Holy Ghost, as if to say, whoa, so you would not have obeyed me, because you would have been afraid of offending her or anyone. And this reminded me of Jeremiah chapter 1. When I was a child, 12 years old, the first scriptures that the Lord opened to me was Jeremiah chapter 1. And for those of you who are familiar with Jeremiah chapter 1, this is when God calls Jeremiah. But I want to speak specifically about verse 8 that says, be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Right? And also verse 17 that says, thou therefore gird up thy loins and arise and speak unto them all that I command thee. Be not dismayed at their faces, lest I confound thee before them. And so the Holy Spirit checked me at that time and reminded me, I did not call you on here to present a socially accepted gospel, to present a gospel that would be offense-free. Your intention is not to come on and to purposely offend, but the purpose for which I'm here must stay uninfluenced by soul ties and relationships and friendships. You know, we have enough dealing with people who are hiding behind fake profiles, telling lies, pretending, deceiving, and so many other things. You know, ghostwriters, ammunition hunters. Ammunition hunters are people who write you with, you know, fake profiles, and they tell you the most intimate details of their lives and ask you what your perspective is of it. Only to gain your perspective on that topic and use it later as ammunition against you. You know, people who use your channel to fight with other people or to send messages to other people. I've experienced it all. I've experienced people who have given me, you know, I'm not going to hold my tongue back on this one. So I've experienced people who have given me shout outs, not knowing that that shout out was only to send a message to someone else. Okay. And, you know, there's so many things. I personally, if you are a new minister on this type of platform, do not take shout outs seriously, which I have never done. I, in fact, discourage them. Many of you have written to me wanting to do shout outs. I said, no, don't do that. Okay, please don't do that. Because many people who give you shout outs today, they will be shouting you down tomorrow. Okay, or some other thing. But I needed to speak on this, but the Holy Spirit instructed me prior to share the Word of God. So those who are called to this channel will hear why I have made the changes that I've made. They won't just hear flesh. They won't just hear a person speaking. Okay, they will hear from the ears of the Spirit, those who are called. Those who are not, they will just pick out little things and make whatever they will make out of it. Okay, so for those of you who are in ministry, I encourage you to proclaim what God has called you to proclaim. Be careful of soul ties. Be careful of clicking. Be careful of getting your focus off of anything other than the purpose for which God has called you here for. All right. I may open up another channel for other reasons that I will not even link to this channel. If you find it, you find it. Okay. Just like the Lord, if he led you to this channel, you found this channel, you'll find the other ones. All right. So I just wanted to share this and let you know why I've made the changes, why I've closed down the contacts. I won't allow anyone to use this channel to as a canvas for them to paint whatever message they want to paint and send to others. But what was a real kicker is that I saw souls being swayed. I've seen people swaying the souls of men. I've seen souls being influenced by spiritual, they may not be natural witches, but people who are witches, who are manipulating, who are cunning and crafty, and who are just swaying. I've watched and observed people take people out one by one. I've seen them sway people one by one. And I just want to come on. The flesh wants to come on and yell, "Can't you see what's happening?" I mean, yell at the top of my voice. But the Holy Spirit has not given me permission to do that. You know, my prayer is that your eyes will be enlightened, that you will be led by the Spirit of God, that you will walk circumspectly, and that you would be as those who are ready for meat and not just milk. Amen. And that doesn't mean that we have to walk around super deep. I am one of the, you will enjoy being around me if you knew me. You know, people tell me that I'm funny, that I make them laugh. And really, I don't intend to make you laugh. It's just how I am. And it's just the way the Lord has allowed me to be able to see things. So when I see something from that kind of perspective, sort of like a horse that has the blinders on the side, I'm not distracted by a lot of things. So I can kind of pinpoint into that thing. And after I've zeroed it in and, you know, weighed it and sifted it through the Word of God or sifted it through God's wisdom, I often say something and people think it's funny, but they get revelation from it. So if you knew me personally, you would like me, I believe. And then many of you would not like me. You know why? Because I am just like what I present when it comes to the Word of God. I'm not just saying something just to be saying it. And so for that reason, some people will be repelled. Many people will be repelled because I am what I'm preaching. I've dipped, I've tipped, I've slipped, I've sinned, I've wallowed in sin and all these other things. But Christ has come and he's changed my heart. He's changed my life. He's changed my mind. And I want to share that change with you. And that's the only purpose for which he's called me here. So for that, I've made these changes. And to the beloved saints of God that he has called to this channel, doesn't mean that you're not a beloved saint of God just because you haven't been called to this channel. But to those that he's called to this channel, I wanted to give you this explanation. I know that you hear what the Spirit is saying to us. I know that you get it. And for those who don't get it, I make no apologies because I am saying what the Lord would have me to say. But I do warn you, I am not into open rebuke, but I do warn you, those who are swaying souls and people's lives are being led astray, if the Lord leads, I will rebuke you openly, not for the purpose of calling names, but for those who are taking babes in Christ and leading them away, not even with a false gospel, but making them choose between you and someone else. That is very dangerous to do because you're causing people to slide back. You're causing them to become carnal. You're causing them to be turned away from the gospel unto another gospel. It's not even a biblical gospel. You know that there are gospels that have nothing to do with the Bible. There are worldly gospel. Those who are spiritual, you caught that one. But be very careful. And those who are babes in Christ, don't be so easily swayed. Keep your mind on what is important. Keep your mind on Christ. Keep your eyes on Him, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of your faith. Amen. Don't be so easily swayed. Don't be so carnal. Don't be so fleshly. Don't be so anxious to be in good standing with man and not in good standing with God. I've had people who no longer contact me on the channel, but they contact me secretly because they are afraid of those whom they are trying to impress. Enough of the foolishness. I won't allow this channel to be used that way. All right. So God bless you all. God keep you. I will be away for a while, so don't worry. And as I read about Sosthenes and Epaphroditus and Timotheus, perhaps if I'm gone for a while, I'll send one of them to you. All right. God bless you. Have a wonderful day in the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.